bring in now Monica Medina into this conversation. She's former Assistant Secretary of State for Oceans and International Environmental and Scientific Affairs. Also with us, Dr. Derek Manzello, the coordinator of NOAA's Coral Reef Watch Program. We'll start there, Doctor. We were talking a little bit about this on Friday, this global coral bleaching event that the world is enduring. What is it, and what's the impact on the environment?
Well, since February of 2023, we have seen mass coral bleaching confirmed in at least 54 different countries in both the northern and southern hemisphere in all three ocean basins. Now, corals are an animal. They live in a symbiosis with a very simple type of algae. Now, these algae actually provide about 95% of the nutritional requirements of the coral animal. However, this relationship is very sensitive to elevated temperatures. So if temperatures are elevated by about a degree Celsius, which is about 2 to 3 degrees Fahrenheit, and they stay there for about a month or more during the warmest part of the year, corals start bleaching. Thus, when you see a white coral, it's essentially starving to death. Now, bleaching isn't a death sentence. Corals can recover. But even for those corals that do recover, they have lasting physiological impacts. So a coral that bleaches and recovers will have slower growth rates for about 2 to 4 years. Its reproductive output will go to about zero for about 5 years, and they become immunocompromised such that they're highly susceptible to disease for 1 to 2 years. So corals are vitally important because they're the engineers of the coral reef ecosystem. So without corals, you no longer have a coral reef ecosystem. And the reason that's so important is because about 25% of all known marine species associate with coral reefs at some point in their lives. So 1 in 4 of every living thing in the world's oceans is dependent on healthy coral reefs.
Well, and Monica, you look at the rising temperatures and the warnings that Steve Rattner just gave us on the charts that in heated waters, a lot of fish, just as he said, would die, and it keeps getting worse.
Absolutely, Joe. Thanks so much, Joe and Mika, for having me on today to talk about this important topic. We couldn't be at a more perilous place when it comes to our oceans because they're heating up extremely fast. The temperatures are off the charts. It impacts fisheries, which billions of people depend on for their primary source of protein. And in addition, today's Earth Day, the theme is planet or plastic. And we are seeing an inundation of plastic pollution in the ocean as well. There are 21,000 pieces of plastic in the ocean for every person on this planet. So our oceans are getting walloped, and we're finding plastic in our food web, in us. So I really think today we ought to be thinking about this as people or plastic, because plastic is incredibly harmful to humans. And there's a global environmental negotiation going on today, right now in Ottawa, Canada, to try and get a handle on this horrible plastic pollution problem that's really damaging both the environment and humans.
So that's my next question for you, Monica. How does this happen? Because reading some of the information that that goes along with this, you're right. It's showing up in breast milk. It's showing up in human tissue, in the digestive tract. There's connections to cancer and plastic. And also, if you look at the American household, every single day, plastic is used. Plastic is thrown away. How do we root this out of, I'll just start with the United States of America, in terms of our lifestyle?
Well, there are lots of things that individuals can do, but it also takes leadership. So as an individual, you're out there in your kitchen, you probably just threw something plastic in your trash can. Think about all the ways that you can cut your own plastic use, reusable water bottles, or go to the grocery store and instead of buying a big jug of detergent in plastic, look for the little containers of plastic, sheets of detergent that you can just throw in your washing machine. Incredibly easy to use and very efficient and effective. There are substitutes. But on top of that, we need leadership at the state, local, and national levels. And President Biden and Vice President Harris have been at the forefront of trying to get their arms around this plastic pollution problem. From cutting it out of our drinking water, there are 95% of U.S. drinking water systems have plastic in them. The Biden administration just promulgated a rule to take some of the most toxic forever chemicals, the most toxic of these chemicals, out of our water systems. They've also just promulgated a rule to take it out of the air. Every person every year inhales 22 million pieces of plastic, microplastic, a year. So getting it out of the air is incredibly important. And the Biden administration has taken this on. And the Trump administration ignored this problem because, of course, they cared more about what the chemicals industry and the oil and gas industry cared about than about what people need and what people cared about. And by the way, plastic is the lifeline for the oil and gas industry, because as we cut back on our use of oil and gas in cars and transportation, increasingly we're ramping up our plastic production, and every piece of plastic that we have ever made is still in the environment because it never degrades.
Former Assistant Secretary of State for Oceans and International Environmental and Scientific Affairs, Monica Medina, and coordinator of NOAA's Coral Reef Watch Program, Dr. Derek Manzello. Thank you both very much for coming on this morning for this important conversation.
Hey, everyone. MSNBC has a new and improved app. You'll get real-time alerts and analysis, live blogs, in-depth essays, video highlights, and the best 2024 election coverage. Download the new MSNBC app. Here's how to do it. You tap on the App Store on your phone. You hit search on the bottom right corner. You type in MSNBC. You click on the MSNBC app. You click on Get or the cloud icon and enjoy it.